Do you want early access? Do you want uncut reactions? If so, then check out our Patreon. Link in the description down below. We're now on to episode 5 of Overlord. This one is called In Pursuit of the Land of Dwarves. So, dwarves.
Butters me drink. Butters me drink.
Rock and stone, brother.
Where's my drinks? The World of Warcraft voice line.
Okay, I didn't know that. Once again, I didn't play WoW as much as you. Imagine them just going to this. Is this the land of dwarves? And all of a sudden, it's like Brad Williams is there, and he's just like,
"Hey, what the hell is that supposed to mean?"
If y'all haven't seen Brad Miller or Brad Williams, y'all should check him out. Guy is hilarious.
Yeah, he's very funny.
Yes. And anyway,
he's like, I like to go to the grocery store and just get one box of Lucky Charms and go out with it because it makes everyone's day that sees it happening.
It would be too. If I saw Brad Williams doing that in real life, I'd be like, you've not only made my day, you have made my life, sir. Thank you. Anyway, so let's go ahead and watch this before we get even further off track. どういうことですか。先に一つ確認したいのだけど、ルシュダンはあったかしら。あります。それはアインズ様に動いていただくという配下として恥ずかしい行為が必要でしたし、最低でも1ヶ月はかかるかと。これを。He literally just did it。様は帝国の従属に関してあなたと私にどうするか決めるよう指示されたわ。
That's so funny. Why would he ask someone incompetent like me? It's like, dude, literally, like, you've been running most of the show since you guys have gotten here and you don't realize it.
アインズ様がドワーフの国に行かれたのも。ええ。私たちには計り知れない深いお考えと複数の意図があってのことだわ。
Brought the lizardmen with him.
He had more than just the lizardmen with him.
Yeah, it looked like ninjas as well.
He had Calchitus and Shaltier there too, I think.
Oh, yeah, yeah. よ気づくというのは本当なんですかい。全部アインズ様のお言葉を疑うとは無礼千万。良い呼吸と。星が長くなるのであれば何かにお賭けになってはいかがでしょう。
Really?
Oh my god. Why? It'd be like, I would literally look at one of the lizard men and just be like, bring your best chair. Here's the thing.
Because that's like literally every single one of his like top brass pretty much. And they probably all have been thinking about that since they saw it being done to Shaltier.
Oh, Jesus. いや、あれは罰を与えるためだ。ならば私が支配している理ザードマン様に言われるようなことも。もうよい。これでしょうか、アインズ様。ジーズクライスト。なかなか良いぞ。それでは私とシャルティア、どちらの方がいい。マイゴッド。
ことを知りたがる。将来私の背に乗ってくださる方のためにも訓練の必要が。ああ、フレイジング。ああ、明美和さん。シャルティアを連れて行く。シャルティアですか。ドワーフの国を滅ぼすということでしょうか。いや、それは経験をさせて成長を図るべきなのだ。
I'm sorry, but I would be tempted to just like ride atop the elephant and also just be like, hey buddy, who's that big? I'd want it to be like the elephant from friggin' George of the Jungle, where it's basically like a big dog.
フォートレス。お。本日はここに宿泊する。各員、部屋で休息を取れ。
Huh.
hope that's far enough away from the dwarves that they don't see that.
All of a sudden, the dwarves, like, on the horizon, just be like, you see anything? Nah, I don't see anything. 10 minutes later, you see anything? Nah, I don't see...
What the... How did that get there?
Frank! Come here. He's excited. この世界にはユグドラシルの知識が点在している。グッチルクニフのやつ、突然属国化だなんて、一体何を考えているんだ？いや、デミウルゴスが何かを仕掛けていたのか？ See? See? Even he thinks Demiurge had something to do with it, because Demiurge is always so ahead of the curve.
大丈夫なの？大丈夫だと思いすけど。
That's me. Anytime I try to take notes on anything, it's like if somebody was like, "Are the notes that you're taking actually helping you?" I think so.
Maybe.
I hope.
I always take the neutral response. It's just like, all I know is that my gut says maybe.
内部に侵入し状況を確認してこい。
Oh.
Uh-oh.
It's an entire underground city.
It looks very empty.
姿はありません。ですが、坑道の奥から何者かが鉱脈を掘る音を確認しました。
Just one dwarf?
こんにちは。何をしているの？ふかしかか。言ったの。
ヘオジュラという、ここから北に6日ほど歩いたところにある町じゃが。お主はまだ子供じゃろう。一人で来たのか？モンスターが出る場所に送るとは、大人の恥じゃと言ってやらねばな。正しい見識の持ち主だな。ゴンドよ。化け物じゃ。慌てるな、ゴンド。
He can't even move her because she's so strong.
ものが ルーンを掘るよりずっと短い時間で作れる。た方がいいと考えるものが多くなってしまったのじゃ。伝統工芸が廃れたということか。じゃが、
you gotta be honest, man. I mean, that I worry about that sometimes with like some analog things being lost forever, because there's some analog things that are really amazing technology that if we lose the ability to make them like analog. And then all of a sudden something happens and digitally we're not able to do it anymore. Like, what are we going to do?
復活し、ルーンでしかできない技術を開発できれば、その価値はさらに増すじゃろう。意思とおぼしき侵入者、およそ100匹を確認。半蔵の一部を偵察させておりんす。なった元凶じゃ。クワゴアは子供の頃、金属を食べて育つせいか、
全身を覆う体毛は金属よりの波の高度での。やかの特殊な色をしているやつは相当の強さじゃ。すべて捉えよ、可能か。ご命令とあれば必ずや。今日こそ汚名を返上するでありんす。さてどうしんしょうか。数は少ない。体勢を立て直せ。ありの指揮官のようでありんす。
マスホールドスピーシーズ。こちらに逃げてきたクワゴアはこれで全部でありんすね。はい、部族の誇りにかけたな。ではご
心証、チャームスピーシーズ。それで何が聞きたいんだ？友達だから刺激してんのか。その通りだよ。 彼女が私の主人だ。さすが我が友。ドワーフどもの年を攻め滅ぼすんだが。なんじゃと。俺たちはその別動隊なんだ。こっちに逃げてきたドワーフを殺してやるんだよ。ルートが見つかったんだよ。そろそろ本体がドワーフどもを皆殺しにしてるはずさ。
Oh, great. Well, better get moving.
Yep.
Damn it. Well, okay, there we go. Just want to make sure there's nothing left. So yeah,
it's a pretty good episode.
Yeah, it introduces the like the dwarves. Although we only see one, it introduces the concept of runecrafting, potentially being something that could lead to some big unknown things, because it's not as prevalent as a method of magic, of like magic, what's imbuing magic onto weapons as like just like regular spell casting. And honestly, he was talking about making it to where it would make rune, like it's doing something that would make rune crafting indispensable, like make it to where it could, like they couldn't go, it was only possible through rune crafting. And I think if someone could like figure that out, it would be it, like the dwarves have the baseline of the technology and they basically have a monopoly on it. If Ainz dedicates enough like resources to it, maybe they could find something that only could be done through rune crafting, and he would be the only one who would have access to it.
Well, I think he's already aware that that's a thing, because that's why he was interested in it at all. Because he already knew that there was nothing that regular magic could do that runes, like if there was nothing that runes could do that regular magic couldn't also do, then he wouldn't have been so interested when he saw the runes, you know.
Yeah.
So he must be very aware of certain things that can only be done with runes. So he's hoping to get them to figure those things out for him, to re-unlock access to things he didn't have access to, except for in terms of whatever he has saved up, probably, from the game.
No, I mean, honestly, I mean, if that's the case, then honestly, who's to say that what... Oh, all right. Okay. Well... Honestly, if it's the case, I mean, what's, like, there's a lot of ways I could see this going. There's a lot of ways I could see this going and being a benefit for, like, the Dwarven Kingdom and for Ainz, and there's also a way I could see this to where, like, this dwarf will basically form its own separate group away from the Dwarven Kingdom, and basically he will be the new leader of, like, the new Dwarven Kingdom. And basically, the old Dwarven Kingdom will be left behind, and will basically be obsolete. And that could be the way it goes. And if it does go that way, it'll be sad. But at the same time, it's just like, hey, no sense in going against Ainz, because if he's not able to like get what he wants, he'll find a way to divide and conquer. He'll find a way to divide and conquer, like. Basically pull a little bighorn, surround all the areas and like suffocate, like surround all like areas where like there's like surround all areas where there are vulnerabilities, and then basically just take what he wants. But
also, runes could potentially be one of the key components to us eventually being able to craft world tier items.
That's the other thing, too.
So.
And that's something that he is very interested in. Because
he only has so many of them that he brought with, and he knows that somebody else has at least one because of what happened to Shaltir,
supposedly. Yeah.
He said was on the same level as like a world tier item.
In which, there you go. Well, I guess we'll see. I mean, all things considered, like, Ainz is very intelligent with his approach on this stuff, and it'll probably be something that, you know, he'll probably have to rush to the new Dwarven Kingdom and defend it somehow.
Yeah.
But
which, coming to someone's defense is a pretty good way of getting them to work with you.
Yeah. So. Case in point, the human village in the very first season, coming to their aid and saving them, that has given them, that gave them so much. That gave him so much of a foothold, he literally took over that section of the kingdom. Jesus. Crazy stuff, man. But anyway, yeah, so this was episode 5 of Overlord Season 4, In Pursuit of the Land of Dwarves. Hopefully you all enjoyed, and hopefully we will be seeing you all in the next one. So until then, I'm Nate.
I'm Nick.
Y'all be good people. Take care. Peace.